hope you had a wonderful week. So I have another new book for you to read with me. But first, what do? Before we start reading? That's right, we put on our reading glasses. Let's begin. These are my glasses. This is my book. I put on my glasses and open up my book. Now I read, 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 and I look, look, look. I put down my glasses and whoop, close up my book. So, are you ready? Do you remember this one? Giraffes Can't Dance by Giles, Andreae. Gerald was a tall giraffe whose neck was long and slim, but his knees were awfully bandy and his legs were rather thin. What part of the world do you think Gerald lives in? Maybe Africa? He was very good at standing still and eating shoots off leaves. But when he tried to run around, boom, he buckled at the knees. Many animals. All the animals in the jungle. Now every year in Africa, they hold a jungle dance where every single animal turns up to skip and prance. And this year, when the day arrived, poor Gerald felt so sad because when it came to dancing, he was really very bad. What sort of animals can we see? We have some zebras. Oh, lions. And some buffalo. Hippo. Elephant. Cheetahs, monkeys, cheeky monkeys, and our hero, the giraffe, Gerald. The warthogs started waltzing. And the rhinos rock and rolled. The lions danced a tango that was elegant and bold. Dum, doo-dum, doo-dum, dum, dum. The chimps all did a cha-cha with a very Latin feel. And eight baboons teamed up to do a splendid Scottish reel. Gerald swallowed bravely as he walked towards the floor. But the lions saw him coming and soon began to roar. Hey, look at Gerald! The animals all laughed. Giraffes can't dance, you silly fool! Oh, Gerald, don't be daft. Is that nice? All the animals laughing at Gerald? I don't think so. Gerald simply froze up. He was rooted to the spot. They're right, he thought. I'm useless. Oh, I feel like such a clot. Oh, poor Gerald. Poor Gerald. So he crept off from the dance floor and he started walking home. He'd never felt so sad before, so sad and so alone. Look, all the other animals are having a party. And how do you think Gerald feels? Very sad and lonely. Then he found a little clearing and he looked up at the sky. The moon can be so beautiful, he whispered with a sigh.
Excuse me.
Who said that?
Excuse me.
Coughed a cricket. Can you see the cricket?
Me?
Coughed a cricket, who'd seen Gerald earlier on.
But sometimes when you're different, you just need a different song. Listen to the swaying grass and listen to the breeze. To me, the sweetest music is those branches in the trees. So imagine that lovely moon is playing just for you. Everything makes music if you really want it to. It's a very wise cricket. There's Gerald. What's he doing? Looks like he's meditating, but he's listening. Listening to the music in the trees. With that, the cricket picked up his violin. Oh, look at that, it's so cute. Then Gerald felt his body do the most amazing thing. His hooves started shuffling and making circles on the ground. His neck was gently swaying. And his tail was swishing around. What's happening to Gerald? He threw his arms out sideways and he swung them everywhere. Then he did a backward somersault and he leapt up in the air. Gerald felt so wonderful. His mouth was open wide. I'm dancing. I'm dancing. I'm dancing! Gerald cried. Wow, look at that. There he is. Boogieing on. Go, Gerald. What an amazing dancer. Then one by one, each animal who'd been there at the dance arrived while Gerald boogied on and watched him quite entranced. They shouted, oh, it's a miracle. We must be in a dream. Gerald's the best dancer that we've ever seen. How is it that you dance like that? Please, Gerald, tell us how. But Gerald simply twizzled round, whoop, and finished
with a bow. Thank you. Thank you.
Bravo! Bravo, Gerald! Bravo!
Then he raised his head and looked up at the moon and stars above. We all can dance, said Gerald, when we find music that we love. The end. That was a nice book, isn't it? I think it's time for an ice cream now that the weather's getting nicer. So, you got your cones ready? We can have three scoops. Let's begin. I dream of ice cream in a cone with a cherry on top. I dream of ice cream. It's cold and I like it a lot.
Three scoops.
One scoop of strawberry, one scoop vanilla, one scoop of chocolate fudge. Yum! I dream of ice cream in a cone with a cherry on top of the lot. In a cone with a cherry on top. Good appetit! Oh, that was delicious. I'll see you next time.